Okay, so welcome here to Geneva, where we are going to visit IDQ, a spin-off company from my university group at the University of Geneva, where I'm leading the Department of Applied Physics. And the goal is to visit this company, which is a pretty successful company with about 40 people today that we founded with colleagues and students already 15 years ago in 2001. It's not Google. But nevertheless, we are producing real stuff, the kind of stuff that you have heard about during the lectures on quantum information theory. Here it is made concrete. And we're going to see, one side first, the R&D department, and then next, also the production department. So please follow me. So here we come into the main entrance, and as you can see, quite busy people, and what we are producing here are actually three kinds of products that you have all heard already about during these lectures. One, and maybe the most fascinating one, is quantum key distribution. You know how to distribute cryptographic keys whose security is guaranteed by the law of physics. Now, when you do that, when you produce QKD, you anyway need also quantum random number generator. And so a second line of product that we are producing here, a quantum random number generator, which maybe funnily enough are also used a lot for internet lotteries and internet gaming in general. And another product that you also need in QKD systems are single photon detectors. So here we also produce single photon detectors, mostly for photons compatible with the standard telecom optical fibers. So these are all kind of things that we are going to see. But other things that you also need in order to have a successful company in this field, or actually in company in any field, is support and salesperson. So for instance, in the offices that you see here on both sides are the offices of our salespersons. One has to remember that it is the salespersons that bringing the money in the company. So these are kind of very central and important persons, and different kinds of persons from the physicists that most of us know. Other important persons are the admin support that are absolutely needed, are essential also in any company, including in a QKD company. Okay. So maybe I can now suggest that we go to the R&D department, which is just behind this door. So here you see that there are quite some people working here. And obviously, many of these are physicists. And many of these physicists, if not all, are coming from my university group, either former students or former collaborators that work now here at IDQ. But important is also to understand that the majority of these people in this R&D department are not physicists. They are maybe electronic engineers or software engineers or mechanical engineers, cryptographers. Of course, we also have people who are specialized in patents. Patent is also an important aspect in any company, especially a high-tech company like IDQ. So you see that you have all these kind of persons. Ah, Mathieu. Hi.
Hi, Nicolas.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well, thank you.
So what are you doing? You're working on this beast here?
Yes, so I'm working on the integration of QKD technology in a blade that will fit this ATCA chassis.
What is an ATCA chassis?
So an ATCA chassis, it's a chassis which is standard in telecommunication companies.
Okay, so it's compatible with telecom devices.
Exactly. And the goal is really to allow the implementation of large-scale quantum networks used by those telecom companies. In
fact. I see. And so what is missing here?
So here, this is the location where the QKD blade will be, in fact.
Okay, so a very compact QKD system. And these things?
So either we can put QKD blades also in order to have a large quantum networks or encryption devices to use the keys.
Of course, we need encryptors and decryptors in order to make use of these quantum keys.
Exactly.
And what else? Maybe for the trusted nodes also?
Exactly. So we can put a key manager device in order to to implement a full trusted node for large quantum.
So all that would, at the end of the day, do QKD, the quantum part, the encryption, decryption, and the trusted
and
node.
And the trusted node.
Everything comes in such an ATCA standard.
Exactly.
Excellent.
A quite compact chassis. Yes.
Excellent. Impressive.
Thank you.
So we see that we have more people here working. And maybe I would suggest that we go on. The department extends behind this door, where I see that we are lucky today. We can have a look at this QKD system, which is probably on the advanced and final test. So this is actually the QKD version for the physicists, for the students, what we call here a clavis system. And all that gets into these small blades that we just saw before. And I think this is now the right time to go on to the production department. Okay, here we are now in the production department, where we see, for instance, here small series. We make small series of different kinds of stuff. Here are single photon detector with steering cooling that are all on the test, almost ready to be shipped. And if we continue, we get here now in the main part of this production service, where I see that we have, for instance, here the electronic boards of quantum random number generator. These get then in these kind of boxes, little boxes here. And each of these box is able to produce 4 megabits of random number generator, really of quantum origin. So here on this PCI blade, you see that we have 4 of these boxes, so we can produce up to 16 quantum random number generator per second. I mean, most of these electronic boards are outsourced. Let's continue. Here also something interesting. You see here a QKD blade. This is really the kind of blade which will go into these racks, these ATCA racks that we saw before in the R&D department. So you see how compact it is. So here in you have really the single photon detector, the sources, the random number generator, all the electronics to do all the post-processing required for quantum key distribution. And if we continue, here is an example of a QKD engine, but now that's the version for the physicist. So it's much more open, much more accessible. It's also not finished yet. Again, it's most empty, but I mean, it's production. And just seeing that here you also have several chassis or steel frames, which will eventually become also single photon detectors. And all that, which is produced here, again, mostly outsourced for the components part, but when the assembly is done here, and eventually all that ends up in boxes, ready to be shipped to the final customer. So I hope you enjoyed this visit. I think what is really interesting, what certainly fascinates me, is to understand that quantum physics goes from fundamental ideas, fascinating ideas, to commercial products.